Hello, North Valley kids. It's me, Brian, and I'm so excited to be with you today. In just a minute, we're going to be looking at another story about how Jesus is not afraid to answer some hard questions. But before we do that, let's sing these songs together. Well, I hope you enjoyed singing those songs. Now remember, last week we saw how Jesus entered Jerusalem on a donkey. Many people were excited, but there were some people who weren't. They didn't think Jesus really was the next king. And so they were trying to trick him and trap him by asking him some really hard questions. But Jesus, as you know and I know, is able to see through all of that. And he answered every question with wisdom and authority. But now let's go ahead and watch this video and we'll see how Jesus handles these tough questions.
Hello friends, it's me, Megan, and this is Jesse. Megan, wanna try to answer a riddle?
Sure.
Do you know what a riddle is?
Yes, a riddle is a question that is tricky to answer.
Good, okay. What comes down but never goes up?
Rain.
How did you know that?
I've heard that one before.
Oh, okay. Well, what gets wet while it's drying?
A towel.
Oh, man!
I'm sorry, Jesse. I'm good at riddles. You know who else is good at answering tricky questions?
Who?
Jesus. In today's Bible story, some of the religious leaders tried to trick Jesus by asking him hard questions. But no one can trick Jesus, and no question is too hard for him. Listen to the story.
The religious leaders heard Jesus' teaching, and they decided to try to trick him by asking him a question. Some men went to Jesus and said, "Teacher, we know you tell the truth. Is it right to pay taxes to Caesar or not?"
"Why are you trying to trick me?" Jesus asked. Then he told them to show him what money they used to pay taxes. The men brought him a coin. Jesus asked, "Whose picture is on the coin? Whose name is on it?" "Caesar's," they said. Jesus said, "Then give to Caesar what is Caesar's and give to God what is God's." The men were amazed and they went away.
Whoa.
Later, the religious leaders asked Jesus, "Teacher, which command in the law is the most important of all?" Jesus answered, "Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and with all your strength. The second most important command is like it. Love your neighbor as yourself."
A man said to Jesus, "That's right. Loving God and your neighbor as yourself is far more important than offerings and sacrifices." The man's answer was wise, and Jesus said to him, "You are close to God's kingdom." Then Jesus asked the religious leaders, "Whose son is the Messiah?" "David's son," they said. "How can that be?" Jesus asked. "David called the Messiah Lord. Why would he call his own son Lord?" The religious leaders did not know what to say, so they did not ask Jesus any more questions.
When the religious leaders asked Jesus questions, he answered with wisdom. Jesus is the Messiah, the Son of God. He came to show us what God is like. Jesus has power in heaven and on earth.
Well, I hope you guys enjoyed seeing that and remembering that Jesus is God. Like, he's amazing. Like, he can see through all of the difficulties that sometimes we struggle with. But now I want to go ahead and look at our big picture question together. Our big picture question is, what did Jesus do to save us? Jesus died on the cross and rose from the dead. And that's the good news, right? Jesus endured some pretty difficult things for us and died on a cross to save us. That's awesome. That's exciting. All right. And now let's look at our memory verse. Our memory verse for today is Philippians 2:8. He humbled himself by becoming obedient to the point of death on a cross. And that just means that he went through really difficult things. He humbled himself, even though he could have been like, "Nope, I don't want to do this." He didn't. He suffered and died for us and ultimately rose from the dead so that we could have forgiveness of sins. All right, and now let's go ahead and sing this song to help us remember the verse. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed singing that song, and hopefully it is encouraging to you that he humbled himself for us and was obedient even to death on a cross so that we might have a life with him. Let's pray together. Jesus, we thank you for the story. We thank you that you are wise and you have authority over difficult questions and even over death. Help us to trust you every day. In Jesus' name we pray, amen. All right. Well, guys, thanks for tuning in. Can't wait to see you again soon. Bye-bye.